Well, it could take search to the new level. If you think about Google, search really hasn't innovated in about 20 years. The only thing that's changed about search is that there's more and more ads that are less and less obvious or less and less transparent that they're ads. Remember when you initially did a Google search 20 years ago and there were two blue shaded first returns that said ad? Now they've taken those shades away, and sometimes 60, 70% of the first page are not necessarily a place that takes you to the best answer, but it takes you to a place that Google can further monetize. And their incentives have made them very disruptible, because what ChatGPT and sort of AI-driven or language structure-driven search does, it says, okay, rather than offering you dozens and dozens of answers that might be somewhere between 30 and 70% accurate, we think we can give you one that's sort of 60 to 80% accurate. And the reason, I mean, Google, it's a classic innovator's dilemma, Ian. Google had this technology. Google developed a lot of it, but doesn't want to undermine or disrupt an unbelievable $150 billion toll booth business model and give people the best answer. They want to give them a lot of answers. So I think the first kind of industry to be disrupted, if you will be search. Now, whether or not it holds the same promise, I think it holds huge promise around unstructured data sets to feed in all of your health records and then start making interesting predictions or things you should be at least cognizant of in your own health. But it would strike me that it has huge applications around technology and disrupting traditional players. And then we're probably going to see all sorts of applications in healthcare. I also wonder what it means for our Defense Department in terms of scenario planning, but that's more your bailiwick. The people who might end up having the rare earth material here are the people who have control and produce really robust data sets. I mean, as much as I'm not a fan of Elon Musk and Twitter, you wonder if Twitter, if someone were to say to me that Elon Musk got his $45 billion back, that somehow we recovered that $45 billion equity investment, which has been vaporized as of now, I would guess that an artificial intelligence engine found a way to take the unstructured data set that we produce every day in terms of mood, emotion, what we're talking about, what news is trending, and that he licensed it and got huge dollars for that data set that we produce every day on Twitter. So whether it's health information, weather information, sports information, you know, there are going to be a ton of companies that pop up that do nothing but collect, structure, and feed data sets into these beasts that will have insatiable appetites. I mean, it's kind of the difference between light crude and Texas West Intermediate. I think that's going to be the real value here will be the people who control the most interesting and robust data sets.
Yeah, I mean, and given the real-time connectivity that so many people around the planet have on social media, I mean, you could imagine that the fastest way to find out about an emerging new pandemic or even, you know, sort of your latest flu wave would be much more effective through a data set like that, which so far has been relatively unmined for that scientific purpose, at least, and monetizable.
Yeah, it just reminded me, and it's a weird analogy, but Secretary Buttigieg is talking about, they asked him what infrastructure investment he was most excited about, and he said smart sewers.
I would argue, other than books, it's the most important technology ever.
You put sensors in sewers, and they can tell when COVID is spiking in an area. Could Twitter be a smart sewer? And that is, could it wade through all of the material and waste and find out interesting things around what's trending, where people are starting to get angry, where people are starting to become, you know, could you, at when there's violence across nations, will you be able to get to a point where you can predict that with greater accuracy based on the way people are behaving and the sentiment and the language they're using on Twitter?